Well, only an eternal optimist would have thought there would be any sort of breakthrough from the peace talks today. Both sides are so vastly separated by their positions, but there was never really any hope that they'd be able to come together on this issue today. But one glimmer of hope is that they've at least agreed to come back together again and talk in coming days. The reality on the ground, there was no peace here in several of the major cities around Ukraine. The violence resumed and the ferocity of the Russians, just astonishing.
Huge explosions have again rocked Kiev, a Russian airstrike taking out a radar facility, the Kremlin warning civilians to leave the city. And in Ukraine's second largest city, Kharkiv, the shocking sight of cluster bombs raining down on residential neighbourhoods. Dozens of civilians are thought to have been killed, hundreds injured. A shopping centre targeted, the use of such indiscriminate weapons may well constitute a war crime. The best hope for peace came earlier in the day when helicopters flew the Ukrainian delegation to meet the Russians. But for any deal acceptable to the Ukrainians, the Russians would have to perform a massive climb down, and that's unlikely. Ukraine's President Zelensky today signed a formal application to join the European Union. His latest message was directed at Russian soldiers.
Occupant.
4,500 Russian invaders have already been killed, he said. Leave your weapons behind and go. Don't trust your commanders. Don't trust their propaganda. Unverified video shows captured Russian soldiers. This young man is allowed to phone his mother. We thought we were peacekeepers, he said. They are bombing the cities hard here. In a southern Ukrainian city, Russian soldiers have been left in no doubt about how unwelcome they are. In Kiev, electronic street signs now bear messages for Russian troops. Putin has lost. The entire world is with Ukraine, this one says. The city's mayor says the Ukrainian defense is resilient.
We're impressed, but not depressed.
Uncertain days ahead, but the Ukrainian people show no sign of giving in.
There have been disturbing reports overnight as well from US intelligence sources saying that Belarusian government might as well be deploying troops into Ukraine. That would make it the third country to be involved in this conflict. A deeply disturbing development. The West is already warning that if they decide to make that move, they will face the same types of economic sanctions that are now hammering the Russian economy.
A rare emergency session of the United Nations General Assembly is underway, with members calling on Russia to immediately end its invasion of Ukraine. Let's go to US Bureau Chief Ashley Mullaney in Washington now. Good morning, Ash. It's the first meeting of its kind in 40 years.
Jody, a historic day. Not since 1928 has the General Assembly convened a meeting of this kind, giving every member nation the opportunity to address this crisis in Ukraine. Among them, the Ukrainian representative at the UN. He used his time on the floor to read out a text exchange between a Russian soldier and his mother moments before he died, where the Russian soldier said, "Mama, I'm afraid. We're bombing all the cities, even targeting civilians." He says that he'd been lied to. We were told that they would welcome us, the soldier said. Take a listen to the Ukrainian representative.
As the level of the threat to the global security has been equated to that of the Second World War, or even higher, following Putin's order to put an alert Russian nuclear forces. What a madness.
The global fallout continues after the invasion of Ukraine. Today, the Russian ruble tumbling to record lows. Overnight, to Switzerland foregoing its neutrality, announcing that it too would be following in the steps of the EU in implementing sanctions. Now, that's expected to hit Russian oligarchs particularly hard. It's estimated there is some $11 billion parked in Swiss banks that will now be frozen. And in breaking news just in the last hour, FIFA has announced that they are also banning Russia from the 2022 World Cup. Major news in the sporting world. Here in Washington, the US president has returned to the White House, holding meetings right now with allies as they decide on what step to take next in its approach to this crisis. Jody.
Okay, Ash Mullaney, thank you. Australians have been issued a stern warning not to travel to Ukraine as civilians answer calls to fight against Russia. A legal loophole could see dual citizens enter the conflict zone, but at the risk of their own citizenship here.
At the Ukrainian embassy, the phone is ringing off the hook.
Significant amount of calls, actually it's ringing right now.
Ukrainian Australians answering a call to arms from Kyiv to help defend their mother country.
In the first half of the day it was 20, but as of today maybe 50.
President Vladimir Zelensky is assembling a foreign legion, his foreign minister tweeting, "Together we defeated Hitler and we will defeat Putin too."
I can understand absolutely the strong feelings and the motivations for people to go and do that.
But warns dual citizens who do could be in breach of foreign fighter laws, which can strip them of their Australian citizenship.
At this time, the legality of such actions are uncertain.
Government sources tell 7 News it's unlikely the laws would be enforced, but the advice for Australians remains not to go for their own safety.
The question of whether people should go or not, it's their call, but there are other ways of supporting Ukraine at this point in time from Australia.
Like sending money for weapons. As the government issues a travel warning, that was expected.
We now advise Australians not to travel to Russia.
And for the hundreds of Australians in Russia, to leave immediately while they can. Mark Riley, 7 News.